Yeah, you know, there's a lot of talk all over the country about Dusty Rhodes and what he's been doing and where he's been hanging out since he came back. The thing is, you got to understand that Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, is back, and there's nothing at all wrong with what I've been doing. And there's a lot been going down, and we've been hearing a lot from a lot of people. The Purple Haze is coming for Dusty Rhodes. Purple Haze is looking for him. Well, these my boys in here, Phil Swain, Captain Lewis, to Alan Sugarberg, they're all here. And this is what we do when we just want to kick down. But I want you to meet somebody real special to me. You know, you've heard through the years about family and what makes Dusty Rhodes so tight with his family. And the reason is 6'9", 345 pounds. I want you to meet Barry Windham's dad, Black Jack Mulligan.
Dust, I want everybody to stop everything they're doing just for a minute and listen to what I got to say. There's been a lot of things said about me down through the sport of wrestling, down through football, down through my life. And you know that Barry Windham and Dusty Rhodes and me are blood. I think it's time for the whole world to know and to understand that. And Dust, you know that I love you and Barry. I'd do anything for you. But all kinds of things said about me. I've done a lot of things bad in my life. Maybe I've traveled the wrong road in my life. Every family has got a black sheep. Maybe I hung around some of the wrong people. Maybe I went after the wrong thing. Maybe the wrong values in my life. Maybe I took the easy way out, just shoving my way around and taking and winning any way I possibly can. But that's the only way I know. And let me tell you something, Dust, he's not a kid anymore, he's a grown man. He's done something I never done. He's defeated the world champion twice. All the places I've been, all the things I've done, and all the things I've seen. The kid has beat the world champion twice, and he's not a kid no more, he's a man. And there comes a time in every family, I can look at Mama from the kitchen and sit down and listen to what I'm saying right now, because you know, everybody got family troubles. Everybody's squabbling, aunts, uncles, cousins, there's always a little bit of fightings and gossip going around in every family. But there comes a time when the long riders have got to come riding down. They got to put the dusters on, they got to get together. And when you attack the family, blood is blood, brother, and it's sticking water anytime, any place. So what I'm saying to you right now, everybody, the millions of people listening to me right now, no matter what I do the rest of my life, no matter where I go and the things that's said about me and the things that I do, I can guarantee you, brother, I'm going to take care of my family. But Dust, I'm going to ask you this one thing. There's all kinds of things coming down. There's all kinds of evil. I've never seen such. I've sunk to the depths of my life. I've done a lot of things, and I've hung out with some bad people. I know how they act. I know how they react. I know what they do, and I know what they say. People like Kevin Sullivan. I mean, brother, that's coming from pretty heavy. Pretty serious, evil. A lot of talk stuff about a Purple Haze. A lot of stuff about Leroy Brown and he needs his big tail whooped all the way across the bridge. I don't know, Dust, maybe I've been down on the river too long. Maybe I've been hanging out in too many bars. Hell, man, let me tell you something. Everybody's done wrong once at one time or another in their life. But I can guarantee you, you're not going to mess with my family. You're not going to put a hand on my family because that's when I come right. That's when I come around. And I'm going to tell you something right now, Angelo Mosca. If you ever put your hands on my kid again, there will be enough left for you to scatter across any football field.
Mosca and Mulligan still battling it out outside the ring. And, brother, they're gone right past the, there's the ticket window. And this battle's going all the way out into the street.
Well, this looks like they're down there in a truck. This, Gordon, I just can't believe. They're out in the street. They have the remote cameras from the television crew are everywhere. This is just unheard of in professional wrestling. Right here, these men could wind up in jail for fighting in the street. This just can't be done.
Well, they're trying to break him up now. And, brother, did Mulligan catch him with a haymaker? But they're trying to get it broken up. Trying to get it broken up. And Barry Windham, Mulligan's son, trying to break it up. Mulligan... And looks like, Big Daddy, I saw Big Daddy back there, but they're battling again. They couldn't hold Mulligan. They couldn't hold Mosca. They could not hold him down, and they're still battling right square. And they better watch out. Somebody's going to get run over by a Mack truck or something.
Well, it just seems like a wrestling ring or even a building is not going to be big enough to hold these two men when they start fighting and battling. There's so much friction and animosity between these two. Now, here's Big Daddy out there trying to break it up.
The big man, Big Daddy himself, and he's pulled them apart, and I do believe we're going to get order restored. We'll be back. We'll be back in just a moment.